Hello, in this short video we're going to use Grasshopper to create the Hilbert 3D curve, which is basically a fractal mechanism that is created repeatedly inside a box. As we can see here, we have it done here in Grasshopper, like one part of it. And I have to say that since it's a fractal practice and it has repeated tasks, so it's recommended to use a programming language to do these iterations. But I'm doing it using only Grasshopper, which is might not be as good as creating it using C# and Python, but we're gonna try this method and see how that would go. So what I did is I started with one box. I deconstructed to get its points, its vertices. So usually Grasshopper creates boxes with this order of the points, so 0, 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7 on top. But the order of the points is not useful this way. In order for me to create the Hilbert curve, I will need to rearrange the order of these points in a way that gives me this kind of shape. So all I had to do is I got a list item, I got each one of these points, of these vertices, and rearrange them in the same way that I wanted to create my my shape. So now I have them like this, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the way that I wanted to create my polyline, which is exactly what I wanted. So after this, after this point, I am ready to create the repetitions. So basically, like, the main point is to rearrange the order of the points. After that, it's only about repetitions. So I started with the first one. I got the volume of it in order to use its center point. The center point will be useful in creating the rotations. So we have now like a vertical axis as well as horizontal axis that I am doing the rotations accordingly, and then I'm getting a new rotation of the first curve that I used, then moving it to the right place. Now we have it like this. So we created the first two curves. Of course, from the mirror of this curve, from the opposite side of this first curve, we can also redo the same task here to obtain the rotation and the mirror of all of each these points. That's why I recommended using a programming language, because in a script you can just do these iterations very easily rather than doing like using all of these and repeating them step by step. But for now we are having these. Then we're taking each one of these endpoints and finding the right point to link the upper to the down one, then merging all of them and joining the curves. Now we have them as whole curves. After that, with one more rotation, also again with the linking, so we have it now as a full curve that is connected to each other the same way that we intended to have. Only for the purpose of visualization, I created a mesh pipe using this external component. It's called mesh pipe, and gave it a color only for the purpose of visualization. Of course, we still can do the same repetitions one after another. So I'm doing for now only like on the x-axis, and you can maybe do it for the same like on the y-axis as well as on the z-axis, in order to get a full-shaped Hilbert curve. And since all of it's parametrically controlled, then we can use a slider to control our parameters or our design. Thank you for watching, and if you want this document, please write me in the comments. And if you have a better way to do this task, maybe just reach me and tell me about it. Have a good day. See you in the next one.